welcome back for another video, or if you're new here, welcome. My name is Darian, also known as Mrs. G here on YouTube. I am a stay-at-home mama to a little boy named Micah, and I'm a wife to my husband Eric, and I make lifestyle and motherhood videos over here on this channel every single Wednesday, and would love it if you would tag along. Today I'll be sharing with you pros and cons of living in Southeast Alaska. I have been here my entire life, 23 years. I have lived in a little island named Wrangell, and moved across the pond to our rival town, Petersburg, which is just about an hour away by boat. And if you pull up Alaska here, you can see that Anchorage is here, which is what most people have heard of. And here is Juneau, our capital city. And right below Juneau down here is Wrangell, my hometown in Petersburg, right next door. So since I have been here my entire life, I have quite a bit of experience from growing up as a kid to now living here as an adult with a family. And so I am happy to share with you today some pros and cons to living here in Alaska. So the first pro is something that everybody thinks of when they think of Alaska. It is darn right beautiful here. When I look out my window, it looks like it belongs on a postcard. I absolutely love the views that this place has. Living on an island is really cool because you have so many islands around you. So when it's snowy outside, you have the peaked snowy mountains, and you have the beautiful water that the sun just glistens off of. So living here, you never have a dull moment of how beautiful it is. The sunsets, the sun rises, it is breathtaking. However, the con to that would be it's an island. And living on an island does have its pros, that's for sure, but it does have some cons. We are only connected to the outside world by plane and boat. No roads connected to the mainland. We cannot drive anywhere. In Wrangell, we have like 13 miles of paved road. Just moved to Petersburg, so not quite sure how many we have here, but I have driven every single inch of where I live. And that's all that you can do. If you want to leave, you have to fly on Alaska Airlines to get out of here, or take a ferry or a jet boat just to travel and get off the island. Living on an island also does give a little bit of a hard time when it comes to you knowing everybody. Everybody. You can't just throw on some sweatpants, run to the grocery store looking like a slob, and won't run into anybody that you know. I can guarantee you I'll be stuck at the grocery store for 30 minutes visiting every single person. They are always watching you. You never have a free moment. Another pro to living here in Alaska is the endless outdoor activities. From hiking, to fishing, to boating, to snowboarding, skiing, everything you could possibly think of outdoorsy, which is wonderful if you're an outdoorsy person. And you can even make some of them a professional business. My husband and I own a commercial fishing business. He fishes during the summertime and just a couple months out of the year. And that is something that happens everywhere here. Southeast Alaska is a very big fishing community. The outdoor activities are one of my favorite things about living here. I absolutely love to go camping. My family owns a cabin up on the Stickeen River, and we go up there almost every single weekend during the summer to go play and garden and just enjoy being outside. I loved it growing up as a kid. We did not play with phones or play with an iPad. We were outside, and that is one of the main benefits of having a family here. The con to that is there are few activities that are not outside. So during the winter time, if you're not in an area where you can go skiing or snowboarding or things like that, you do have a hard time finding something to do. Living in a small town means that there isn't really an event happening every weekend or on certain days of the week where you can always plan something for date night or things like that. Also, living in Wrangell, we have one main restaurant, and when it closes during the winter, you really don't have anywhere else to go out to eat. You don't have that option of just looking at the clock at 5 and being like, I don't wanna cook, let's go out. With so many activities being outside, if you are not an outdoorsy person, it is very hard to find something to do here. I did notice that when I was going through school, we are very into sports here in Alaska. Sports are kind of what you do. Going through high school, I noticed I was into sports, so I had a ton to do. However, my sister was very into art, and there was not a lot of activities for her surrounding her interests. So that is something that is very difficult here for if you are not an outdoorsy person. Another benefit is this is a small town. You get a small town feel here in Alaska. Even if you're in a bigger city like Juneau or Anchorage, you do get that bit of a small town feel in certain areas. But here on Petersburg, we have about 3,000 people, I believe. Wrangell's 2,500 people year round. And so it is very tight knit and very small. The plus side of that is the grocery stores, the hardware stores, any businesses that you go to, they're all family owned businesses. And so you are really helping your community's economy by putting back into it, and always just focusing on the mom and pop shops is amazing. I love to be a part of that, and just watching our community flourish, it is so cool to see. The con to that is there are no chains. And what I mean by that is we do not live anywhere that has a Target nearby or Walmart or Hobby Lobby, or I mean, even just grocery stores. We don't have any name brand places to go to, Costco. We don't have any of that around here. If you do go to some of the bigger cities, you can find them. However, living on an island where I live, I have to order everything. Everything. Amazon is my best friend. We order everything from food items to toilet paper, paper towels, to any house supplies we could possibly need, any baby supplies that we need for Micah. And also growing up, we had to order everything birthday wise on there. So there's no running out to go grab supplies for a birthday party. If we are gonna have a birthday party like we're gonna do here in a month or two for my son, then we have to order everything a couple of weeks in advance. I know Amazon has Prime and 2-day delivery. That does not happen here. Things come at least a week after you order them. And that makes planning really difficult. We can't just run out somewhere and go grab something if we forgot something. Something that makes that really difficult is I had to order my prom dresses, which doesn't really seem like a big deal when you live here because everybody orders their prom dresses. So it doesn't really mean anything that you don't think you're missing out on anything. However, when you live down in the lower 48, you can go out and pick out your prom dress. You can go out with friends. You can try them on, see what you like. You don't get that feeling here. You don't get that experience. That is something I wish I could have experienced. Unfortunately, didn't have that opportunity. But yeah, anything special like that, when I got my wedding dress, my family and I actually flew to Seattle, Washington. We are actually closer to Seattle than we are to Anchorage. So Seattle is always the stop shop place we go to. And we flew down there for me to actually go try on wedding dresses, pick them out. And then I flew home, and then about 6 months later, flew back down to get fitted and bring it home with me. Everything makes it a little bit more expensive when you have to travel out of state to even get things done. Groceries is another one. Since we do have the mom and pop shops, family owned places, including our grocery stores, our prices are higher. And if you can imagine, we are in Alaska. We don't have any farmers markets or anything like that nearby. So we have to ship everything to our state. And that makes grocery prices insane. When you go down to the lower 48, you definitely get sticker shock because you're just like, I have to buy everything because it's all so cheap and I need it for the house and we're gonna load up on everything. And that is what we do once or twice a year, for sure. And so then you're spending a lot of money all at once. But our grocery shop is very expensive. An amazing thing about living in a small town, especially on an island in the middle of nowhere, is knowing everybody means that you create a community of family. When there is any death or a birth of a child, or any big event that you need help with or anything like that, you have a giant community of people praying for you, sending good vibes to you, donating money if that is something that you need. When I had my baby and came back, there was a food chain that my church put on for me, where each day of the week I had somebody bringing me a meal so I did not have to cook for my family. Or if somebody does pass away, then that family, you can guarantee the next day they're gonna have food galore at their house. People will make sure that you are taken care of no matter what. And that feeling of family is like a security blanket that it helps you know when you're entering into adulthood at 18 that you are going to be taken care of, that if something does happen, your community is like a safety blanket. They have got you. We are a net that we're going to catch you and we're going to help you get back up, and we are going to provide for you in any way that we possibly can. And that is something you don't find everywhere. The con to having a family as your community is there's no privacy. And it could be small and it could be big. Your friends have been your friends forever. So from kindergarten to senior year of high school, you've pretty much been in the same class with your friends. And then it can even get deeper from there. Whereas when I got pregnant with my son, my husband and I went to the clinic to, you know, get the test that confirms it after the home test. And when I walked back out to set up my next appointment, my aunt was working there. She was working in like a back desk. So I'm trying to talk quiet to the front desk lady, and there's no separation. Like, it's a small clinic, so everybody's here. You can hear everything. And I'm like, can I please set up an appointment for so-and-so at this time? And they're like, yeah, how far along are you going to be? Typing on their computer. So my aunt knew that I was pregnant the day I found out I was pregnant. And I didn't even tell my family for 13 weeks. So she had to keep that secret. And she was a boss at that, by the way. She kept that secret. Didn't even say one thing. Not even one hint came out of her. And she's best friends with my mom. Also, the privacy goes a little further when outside of our ER, just happens to be not very great parking. So it's like street parking. So when you're driving by and you see so-and-so's car there, you're most likely gonna get a phone call. You'll be lying in the gurney in the ER and you get a text saying, hey, I saw your car at the ER. Is everything okay? You need anything? Do you need to call your mom? Like, is everything good? So, I mean, that's a plus, but everyone now knows you're at the ER. So I don't really know what one you want. All right, and the last but not least, the pro for living in a small town in Alaska is it's safe. And what I mean by that is kids can go outside, walk to school, walk to mom's work, walk home. You can go to the playground by yourself. You can go home. You're out with your friends playing until the street lights come on, and that's when you know to go home. You really have a childhood when you can walk outside safely and know that you're not gonna get snatched up. You're on an island. It's not really anywhere you could go. And having that freedom to just be a kid, be outside, and as a freedom as a parent to where you can be doing dishes and know your kid is playing in the yard and perfectly fine, you don't have to watch them. Having that safety is wonderful. I am so grateful for living in a small town in Alaska. It does have its pros, it definitely has its cons. There are days when I'm like, I'm never leaving, I love it here. And then there's times when I'm like, get me off this island, I'm booking a ticket right now, we're moving, pick up your things, we're out of here. And those days definitely do happen. But living in a small town, I feel like I have such a big family and have learned a lot and lived in a place that some people don't even get to visit in their lifetime. And it is absolutely beautiful, and I would not change it for the world. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. That lets me know that you like videos like this. And if you are interested in sticking around, please consider hitting that subscribe button down below and clicking that bell notification. That lets you know when I post videos. I do post every single Wednesday. However, I will be throwing in bonus videos here and there, especially throughout the summertime. So if you are interested in sticking around and joining our group, please do that. Thank you so much for sticking around, guys, and I'll see you later.